On average, the Northeast experiences the most number of days of freezing rain throughout the continental U.S. annually. This freezing rain turns into ice on surfaces and can wreak havoc on an area. Ice storms can be some of the most costly weather phenomena to affect the Northeast. Heavy accumulations of ice can bring down trees and power lines, as well as topple utility poles and communication towers. Ice can disrupt communications and power for days, while utility companies repair extensive damage. Even small accumulations of ice can be extremely dangerous to motorists and pedestrians. The devastation in the January 1998 ice storm resulted in several deaths and long-lasting disruption to the region, primarily because people were unprepared for such a significant event. Storm damage was estimated over $3 billion. Millions of customers lost power, some for several weeks, millions of acres of trees were damaged, roads were impassable, and nearly 40 deaths were attributed to the storm across the affected region. The biggest lesson learned by individuals and communities was the fact that preparation is critical. During major disasters, it will be at least several days before the situation improves. So it is imperative everyone has an emergency plan and supplies already in place to make it through. In addition, it is important to pay attention to forecasts and warnings from the National Weather Service, as well as the advice of local emergency personnel, and be ready to act on that before the danger materializes. We've seen that ice can be dangerous, bringing down trees and power lines. But how does it form? Ice at the surface forms from freezing rain, where cold ice crystals or snowflakes fall through a layer of warm air that melts them into liquid form. But as it continues to fall to the surface, the air temperature goes below freezing again, and the water lands on frozen surfaces, freezing upon contact. Power lines and trees can be weighed down by ice or snap trees and utility poles, resulting in power outages which can last for multiple days. Have a backup heating system and/or generator. Remember to keep the generator outside in a well-ventilated area, not inside a garage, carport, basement, crawl space, or other enclosed or partially enclosed area, even with ventilation. Opening doors and windows or using fans will not prevent carbon monoxide buildup in the home. The carbon monoxide from generators can rapidly lead to full incapacitation and death. But carbon monoxide can't be seen or smelled. Even if you cannot smell exhaust, you may still be exposed to carbon monoxide. Remember to pay attention to National Weather Service watches and warnings. Even a little bit of ice can be hazardous. Being aware will help you prepare. The National Weather Service in Burlington issues a freezing rain advisory when a trace of ice is forecast to accumulate and a freezing rain warning with half an inch expected. Stay home during and immediately after hazardous weather. Ice that forms on frozen surfaces will be slippery and difficult to walk on, let alone drive on. Due to the hazardous driving conditions, it is vital to be prepared before the storm. Hazardous driving conditions during the winter season are responsible for about 70% of all wintertime deaths. When the amount of snow or ice is particularly heavy or falls in a short period of time, roads may be impassable and closed to traffic. However, even the slightest amount of snow or freezing rain on a previously bare road can make for extremely treacherous travel. Also adding to the danger is an icy road that may appear to be just wet, and you won't realize the difference until it's too late. If you don't need to travel, then don't. If you do venture out, make sure you know the conditions of the roadways before you travel. Always drive defensively and cautiously. Maintain a slow and steady speed, avoiding sudden stops and starts. Keep alert and be prepared to handle the unexpected. Even after the ice stops forming, trees weighed down from the ice can break and fall. It is also advised to keep a winter storm kit in the trunk of your car in case you get stranded. Some supplies you may want to include are blankets, non-perishable foods, flares, a shovel, a sandbag, tire chains, a flashlight, windshield scraper, and booster cables. For more information, visit us on the web at weather.gov/Burlington, like us on Facebook, or follow us on Twitter.